discuss galvanic cell. Other name of galvanic cell is electrochemical cell or voltaic cell. What is the galvanic cell? Now the device which convert chemical energy into electrical energy. It convert chemical energy into electrical energy. Left hand side, we have to put that anode, zinc rod, dipped in ZnSO4, zinc rod dipped in ZnSO4, and in right hand side, cathode, copper rod dipped in copper sulfate solution. Now that anode and cathode that connect by external wire, and there is a bulb. When electric flow, it will glow. And this U-shaped tube is called soil bridge. It contains some special electrolytes like KCl, ammonium chloride in agar-agar gel. Next, cell representation. How we can represent galvanic cell? We have to place anode always in left hand side and cathode in right hand side. Metal always outside and iron inside. So Zn/Zn2+ it indicate anode. That parallel line that indicate soil bridge. Then copper 2+ iron/copper. That is representation of galvanic cell. Next, cell reaction. Oxidation takes place in anode. Oxidation means release of electron. In anode, zinc release 2 electron to form Zn2+ iron. Oxidation takes place. Cathode reduction takes place. That means gain of electron. Copper 2+ iron absorb 2 electron to form copper. So overall reaction, Zn+copper 2+ product Zn2+ plus copper. So overall cell reaction, Zn+copper 2+ iron product Zn2+ iron plus copper. That is overall cell reaction. When we add anode and cathode reaction, we will get overall cell reaction. Working principle. In anode, each zinc atom release 2 electron and form jet into plus ion and move to the solution. So as the reaction proceeds, anode diminishes in size. In cathode, copper 2 plus ion from solution move to the electrode, absorb 2 electron and convert into metallic copper. As a result, that cathode increases in size. So during this reaction, what happened? Now anode become electron rich because each zinc atom release 2 electron. So anode become electron rich, and cathode, as the electron absorbed by that copper 2 plus ion, cathode become electron deficient. So when we connect these two electrodes by external wire, what happened? Now electron move from anode to cathode. As a result, electricity move from cathode to anode. So when we connect these two electrodes by external wire, that bulb will glow, which indicate that electric current is passed through that conductor. So that is the working principle of galvanic cell. Next, function of soil bridge. First function, it allows the flow of current by completing the circuit. Externally, it connects by that conductor, electrical wire. But internally, these two solutions connect by that soil bridge, that U-shaped tube, which contain KCl and ammonium chloride in agar-agar gel. Second function, it maintains the electroneutrality of the solution. As the reaction proceeds, what happened? That anode solution become positive due to excess of Zn2+, and cathode solution become negative due to the presence of excess SO4-, that is sulfate ion. Now if we not neutralize this charge, what happened? Backward reaction takes place. That means again Zn2+ ion from solution move to that anode, and copper 2 plus ion, it will move from cathode to that solution. That means backward reaction will take place. To prevent that, to prevent this process, we have to use that soil bridge. Now it contains KCl, so anode become positive, anode solution become positive due to presence of excess Zn2+ ion. So Cl minus ion move to the solution and neutralize that positive charge. And in cathode, excess sulfate ion is there, so it become negative. So from soil bridge, potassium ion will move to that cathode solution and neutralize that negative charge. In that way, soil bridge maintain the electroneutrality of the solution. Type of electrode. First one, metal ion electrode. Metal ion electrode. In this case, metal dip into a solution containing its own ion, like zinc dipped in zinc sulfate solution, copper dipped in copper sulfate solution. So that one metal ion electrode. Second one, amalgam electrode. Amalgam electrode. These are similar to that metal metanode electrode. The only difference in this case, metal are taken in the form of its amalgam. Zinc amalgam, Zn2+. So metal are taken in the form of its amalgam. Third one, gas electrode. In this case, inert electrode like platinum dipped into the solution containing ion of the gaseous element. In this case, inert electrode like platinum dipped into the solution containing ion of the gaseous element. Example, hydrogen electrode. Number 4, metal insoluble salt and a soluble salt with same anion with the insoluble salt. Silver chloride. Now silver chloride is sparingly soluble or insoluble? Now KCl, it is a soluble salt with that same anion, that chloride, with that insoluble salt. So that one, metal insoluble salt and a salt, soluble salt having same anion with the insoluble salt. That the metal and some sparingly soluble salt of the metal is dipped in the aqueous solution of some other soluble salt whose anion is same as that of the sparingly soluble salt. EMF of cell. EMF of cell. Now it is the potential difference between the two terminal when no current is withdrawn from that cell. It is the potential difference between the two terminals of the cell when no current is drawn from it. How we can calculate standard reduction potential of a cell? E naught cell. Now E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Not that standard condition. EMF of cell under standard condition is called E naught cell. E naught cell equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Either also is there E naught reduction minus E naught oxidation. Because in cathode reduction takes place, in anode oxidation takes place. So this formula also we can use. That E naught cell equal to E naught reduction minus E naught oxidation. Next, electrochemical series. Electrochemical series. In this case, elements are arranged according to their increasing standard reduction potential. That means at the top, that lowest reduction potential, and at the bottom, that one highest reduction potential. It is the arrangement of element according to their increasing reduction potential. Next, we have to learn what is the significance of that electrochemical series. Now from the electrochemical series, which element act as a oxidizing agent, which element act as a reducing agent, we can easily find. Element having higher reduction potential undergo reduction. Element having higher reduction potential undergo reduction. So as it undergo reduction, it act as a oxidizing agent. If we take that galvanic cell, in case of galvanic cell, that E naught copper 2 plus copper, that one greater than that reduction potential of that copper, that couple is higher than that zinc. That's why here copper it undergo reduction and zinc undergo oxidation. So copper itself undergo reduction, so act as a oxidizing agent. Zinc itself undergo oxidation, so act as a reducing agent. Another thing, second application, we can easily find which one act as a cathode and which one act as a anode. If two metal, which one has higher reduction potential, act as a cathode, and which one has lower reduction potential, act as a anode. Because in cathode reduction takes place and in anode oxidation takes place. So copper reduction potential is more, that's why copper act as a cathode due to higher reduction potential. But zinc act as anode because lower reduction potential.